Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 1744, Excel on the iPhone. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, something a little bit different. I want to talk about the new Office app on the iPhone. Now, this is July 4th, 2013. This is just the first rev of Office on the iPhone. Let's talk about the bad things. Office on the iPhone, well, it's free, but when you download it, you have to sign in to your Office 365 account. Now, if you don't have Office 365, you're going to have to go out and spend $99 to get a subscription. It doesn't matter if you've already given Microsoft the $399 for Office Pro Plus or Office Pro, or if you own 17 PCs where you've already paid for Office, it doesn't matter. You have to go get an Office 365 account. Now, if you've already rented Office 365, well, then you're good to go. This is free, but most people are still buying the DVD. Microsoft doesn't want people to buy the DVD. They want people to rent the software. And this is a clear stake in the ground that, hey, we don't care if you've already given us $400. You're not going to get to use Excel on the iPhone unless you're giving us money every month. All right, so we have Office. You open it up. You're going to associate it with your SkyDrive account, SkyDrive or SharePoint, or email yourself the documents. That's really the only viable way to get documents here. You're not going to want to create an Excel document on the phone. They'll let you create a new Excel document on the phone, but boy, it is just so limited. So here is the Excel screen. All right, we have we can see 18 rows by 5 columns. There are more rows than that, 16,384 rows, 255 columns out to column IV, just like in the old days back in Excel 97 or 2003. Well, that's the number of columns. You'd have to go back to, I think, Excel 5 before you got to 16,384. So you know, you have your Excel document. You can enter text. You can enter numbers. If you want to enter a formula, click up in the formula bar. And then here's another thing that's a little frustrating. This, you know, it's a hassle because you start out with the alpha keyboard on the iPhone, and you then click the number keyboard, and then click the symbol keyboard before you can get to the equal sign to even start the formula. So several clicks there. But you know, the formulas I've entered a VLOOKUP formula. It worked here. 2 raised to the 20th, it accepts that formula. We'll go down a page. You see that we press return there and we get our answer. The keyboard stays up until you click done. All right, so that's, you know, not a big problem. I think the real limitation that we have is the lack of commands. There are so few commands here. I'm gonna go page up a few more times so we get back. This is the menu bar right here. So back goes back to the screen where you can choose recent files. This is essentially file, essentially edit, and view. So you have 3 little icons there to use, and we'll go through each one of those. File is share, that's send via email, save or save as, so you can give something a new name. To make that file menu go away, you click the down button if you decide that you don't want anything there. On editing tools, we have format, and I'll show you the format submenu in a minute, redo, undo, create chart, clear. There was one more that was off the screen, that was auto sum. All right, so I mean, okay, don't think about what's here, think about what's not here. There's so many things that we just cannot do on the iPhone. Like, for example, here's the format cell, so we can do bold, italic, underline. That's great. No double underline. Date, currency with 2 decimal places, percentage, or toggle between text and numbers. No custom number formats, no increased decimal, decreased decimal. For colors, they give you 4 colors, black, green, yellow, or red, and that's the text and the fill color. So I suppose if you really wanted to get down to it, you could have 4 combinations of font with 3 combinations of fill. So, you know, 12 different formats, just really limited. Now, if you create the Excel document on the desktop, on the computer, and download it here, well, yeah, then you get more colors. But to actually create cells here and color those cells, it's just not an option on the iPhone. Under viewing tools, that's the little eye icon. We have outline, sort, apply, filter, and find. Certainly no pivot table, certainly no VBA. So, you know, here's a chart that we created using the create chart. Although this wasn't created using create chart because create chart would not let me add a chart title. There's just no way to customize the chart. I had to create the chart here, take it back up to the desktop, add the title, and go back. So we are incredibly, incredibly limited. Drawbacks, you have to buy a new subscription. So it's essentially a $99 app, which in the world of the iPhone is kind of ridiculous. It needs a better iPhone, iPhone 4 or newer, and it doesn't work with the original generation iPad. I'm not sure about the second generation iPad. It will give you this message. It says, hey, we can't work with this because we need an autofocus camera. You say, well, why do we need an autofocus camera with Office? It's not the autofocus camera. It's some rule that Apple has that they can't specify that you need a certain device, but they can specify that you need a certain feature. Microsoft felt that there wasn't enough power on the original iPad and it would just crash a lot. So rather than have you crash and have a bad experience, they gave you the experience of, no, you can't use your original iPad. The big limiting thing, think about all the things you do in Excel. Control this, control that. All of the special keys, the F4 key to lock a formula down, we don't have any of that. The complete set of commands is here. This is it. So think about all the things you do in Excel that just will not be there. Now, there are some positives. Yes, you can create a full range of Excel formulas. You can enter a formula. That's a lot of calculation power that you wouldn't otherwise have. So I've had it now for a week and a half. Can I find a use? Well, here's the use that I found that I actually like. On my desktop computer, I perpetually have a to-do list, the 60 things I have to do today. And if I have to run out and run some errands, I print that portion of the list, I take that to the store, I cross things off as I go to the next store, cross things off as I go. We're down in Florida working on the new house, and I put that to-do list on the SkyDrive, open it in Excel on the iPhone, and I didn't have to print the list. Now, normally I use Control-5 to strike through, but there is no Control-5 on the iPhone, so I had to come up with something. I put a little X in column A. So the task can be X and A as I finish things, and that allowed me to mark things off. It was nice. I saved when I got back to the desktop, opened it from the SkyDrive, and my list was up to date. Of course, I'm so OCD, I had to go through and use Control-5 to strike through all the things that I had X'd before. Was it cool to have Excel in my pocket? Yes, yes it was. Would it have been worth $99? Well, you know, hey, I could have done the same thing with OneNote or Evernote in sync to the computer, so hard to say. There's also little tiny versions of Word and PowerPoint that I'm sure are just as limited. I can't imagine showing anyone a PowerPoint presentation on your phone. Of course, PowerPoint people probably can't imagine doing anything useful in Excel. I did a VLOOKUP. I was on an airplane at 30,000 feet. I did a VLOOKUP on my iPhone. That was cool. Would I really pay $99 for that? Not sure. The other thing to remember, this is their first attempt. This is version 1. It's going to get better. It's not like we're going to have to wait 3 years for a new version. Probably every 4 months they're going to rev this and they're going to keep adding new features. So someday it might get there. If for some weird reason you already have an Office 365 subscription, then hey, it's free. Go ahead and get it. But if you've purchased Office or you're still in Office 2010 or Office 2007, then yeah, I'm not sure I would go out and give Microsoft more money for this subscription just so you can try this tiny, tiny little version of Excel on the iPhone. Hey, well, there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.